Hi, this is Sire Morton with the daily update on EuroFX. I post my exclusive market overviews with the key political and economical events, charts and important levels on the ForexBSami.com forums weekly. This short video is a response to rapidly changing situation on the currency markets and should help you to stay on top of the game and be profitable. I suggest you to visit ForexBSami.com forum and read my analysis for the week before watching this daily video.
Welcome back, everybody. So let's take a look again on the euro currency. Here we are in 2022. Hopefully you've got a nice time with your relatives, your family on these holidays, and we have no choice but return back to the trading, to the work. So as you could see on Friday, it was really outstanding price performance closer to the end of the year, which is actually we just can't foresee and can't suggest, but this was some foreseeing decision that we have discussed in the morning when we said, well, since we have some long positions and they currently have, I mean, in the morning of the Friday, they have really very small positive result. Maybe it makes sense to keep it and see what will happen in general. So because it's not big sense to close it and with the break-even stops, it is more logical just to keep it. But it's of course not our achievement. It's just, well, sometimes happens. As you can see, market has shown pretty nice rally. So in general, this performance stands in a row with our short-term expectations, as we discussed in the fundamental analysis today, the fundamental report. And actually we said and talked about this in the last week as well, when it was seemed that it is too much fears and priced in the current dollar value, with the understanding that Omicron variant is not as awful in general. Well, it's not really much worse, or maybe not as worse even as Delta variant. So it's really, it's possible to live with it. Some relief coming on the market. And this fear that has been priced in the recent couple of weeks now should be extracted from the price of the dollar. That is a fundamental background for a current upper performance. How deep this performance will be, we will see. But in general, we treat it currently as the first approximation that it might be, well, to test the new yearly pivot point on the euro currency, which stands slightly above the 116 area. So theoretically, it is possible. But we are going step by step, especially because currently, as you can see, euro shows really choppy action and we do not have any signs of the thrusting performance. So yes, the pullback and rally on intraday rally on Friday was nice, but on the daily chart, it doesn't look like something really outstanding. So it's still really choppy. Market still stands around 1380. And the first thing that we should control is that market will not reverse it down again, showing that it might be just a result of the thin market and pre-holidays performance. Hopefully this will not happen, just because this performance, as I said, also has some fundamental reasons to happen, and we suggest that it might and should get the continuation. But with the upper target setting, we're, well, we think that we should control our enthusiasm and go on step by step. And first, we suggest that let's focus on the nearest standing target around 1420 area. So this is actually OP of this ABCD pattern, which is also agrees with the daily overbought area. And you can see the cluster of the Fib level stands around it. So 1447. This is 618 for the thrust that has happened here, and 50% resistance 1440 right from the most recent swing. So I think that it's rather strong resistance for current conditions on the euro currency, and hardly market will pass it on the coming week. So that's, I think, might be used as a primary target over coming week. Risk of the bearish dynamic pressure that we have mentioned previously currently is decreasing. It's just because market finally turns in the same direction as the trend stands. So maybe it will get chance to continue upward action. And finally, that we could say on a daily chart is the major achievement for euro currency currently is the cancellation of the weekly potential bearish grabber that we discussed last week. So with this recent performance, market has canceled this possibility, and this is really big achievement for the bulls that could ride it on the credit side. So let's see how the situation will develop, but currently everything looks not really bad. So on the 4-hour time frame chart, you could see that finally market for this rally hits the 127 extension of the butterfly that we have discussed, and barely washing out the previous some top, showing some minor washing rates, or it's just a reaction on the target. Since the overall acceleration here looks not bad, it keeps nice chances to see that market will proceed later to the 1412, which is also, you can see, once explanation of the 1618 extension of the butterfly, and that agrees with the daily OP. So you can see the parts of the puzzle stands pretty accurate to each other and fits well. Overall picture, technical picture fits well. So it means that in the current condition, our task is relatively simple. So we should control first that market should not form any bearish reversal swing. It means that market has to follow with the high highs and high lows tendency, which in turn means that market has to stay above 113 lows. So in no way market should not drop below it and close below it. Any retracement is possible here, the depth of the retracement, but it has to stay above it. So that's what we see on the 4-hour time frame chart. Speaking on the retracement depth, we suggest that it should not be too significant just by the market mechanics, because just guys suggest that market just has started the upper direction. Previously, we've got two relatively deep retracements that's already passed, and one of them was the COP from the COP target of the same daily ABCD. So the reaction on the COP already stands behind. It means that this should become the extension swing, and on the way an extension, until market hits the major target, the pullback should be moderate. It should not be too significant. That's why on hourly chart, in the beginning of the week, we consider only two nearest standing levels. So primary level to watch for is 35.43. This is confidence support. Also, guys, if you will plot here the Fib level from these lows, from this reaction point, you will see that another 30% retracement level stands in agreement with this one. So that is nice strong support cluster. It also includes the natural support line here. That level is a kind of the invalidation. So it's as it stands very close to the 13 lows. Because if market will break the confidence here, well, hardly lows will hold the price. So although theoretically this one is a vital point, this one is the first approximation to it. So we could treat it as also it's kind of the vital point between the 13 and 13.16 area. So stop, if you would intend to trade euro on long side, the stop should be placed below this area. Or if you would like to, below the confidence level. But that's just for the purest traders, this will be better placed here. Also, we think that we should not discount the importance of the 13.55 area. It's just because since the thrusting action here looks nice, it might be just minor retracement in the brain body trade. So once market hit it, it also could consider taking the long position. So that's two levels for entry. These levels for controlled placing the stop orders. So that's what we have currently on the euro currency. On the higher time frames, we also discussed as usual weekly, monthly charts. On the monthly chart, we update the yearly pivot points for the 2022. So if you're interested with that and using it, just you could find it in a report, and we could report in the form. So let's see what euro will show us in the first week of the new year.